You were expecting the Fanfic Critic, weren't you? And you're thinking, well, you're not the Fanfic Critic, you're not Susan, then who are you? I'm the show's creator. That's right. This episode of Fanfic Critic is not being hosted by the Fanfic Critic, it's being hosted by the creator. Me. Megan Wessels. To be honest with you guys, I did actually film the episode, but, you know, the fanfic has pissed me off so much that I'm just gonna read it as myself and give you my own thoughts on it. Because at this point, it's not gonna be the character talking, it's gonna be the real me talking, so it might as well be me and not the character doing this review. This is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity here. Don't expect this to happen all the time. So let's get started today's fanfic, Evangelion Date Rape. It's a pastebin fanfic. It says that the author is King of the Seahorses. What an intelligent name. It's on pastebin, which the last fanfic I believe I got on pastebin was, I think it was Sweet Apple Massacre. Fond memories. It's one of these fanfics that tries to make rape look like it's okay. Let's put it that way. And I'm not reading the entire thing. I'm just going to read the first story because this is an entire series of stories about, you know, this one character from Evangelion. The main character, Shinji, for those who have watched Evangelion, I'm sure you know that he's not someone who would do this, but it's one of these fanfics like, we're going to make the main character completely out of character! So yeah, they made him into a rapist, sexist pig in this fanfic, so let's not waste any time. I don't own Evangelion, I have no money, so please don't sue me. Masato Katsuragi, date rape. Sorry if I didn't say the name right. Forgive me. I'm not Japanese. I used to watch anime when I was younger. I still kind of watch it now, but that doesn't mean I'm perfect when it comes to pronouncing Japanese names, so please forgive me if I mess up. By the King of the Seahorses. So let's get this over with. Asuka was staying out at Hikari's place tonight, so it was the perfect time to put my plan in motion. Kaji-kun had got me the stuff. He didn't ask me what I needed it for. Masato always bugged me to go to the fridge and get her some more beer. I took the opportunity to drop the small white tablet in the top of the can when I opened it in the kitchen. The dumb slut downed it in one, as she always did. She had thanked me and called me Shinji-chan. I'd show her just how much of a little Shinji I was tonight. I'm probably not pronouncing this drug's name right, so forgive me. The Rahin Pnal was really fast to work. Masato complained of having a headache. Then she was fast asleep, draped over the couch, her bathrobe falling open and revealing one of her big, jiggly, bouncy tits. I got a hard-on straight away. I grabbed her by the arms, dragged her into the bedroom, and dumped her on the bed. Goddamn, she looked fucking gorgeous when she was unconscious. Striping off, don't you mean stripping off, I grabbed her long purple hair and began to play with it, rubbing it on my 6-inch cock and raping it around. Don't you mean wrapping it around? And I love how in a lot of these fanfics I like to exaggerate how big the guy's penis is. Now, I know there are some instances where there could be a cock that, when erect, it could be possibly a foot long, but that's not incredibly common from what I've heard. I nearly cummed straight away. I think the proper term would be came, but whatever. I pulled her bathrobe open and exposed her massive F-cup tits. Even though they were big, they stuck straight up in the air. Okay, guys, really? No, that's not realistic. F-cup is implying to me that the woman's boobs are ginormous, so if he were to remove the shirt, they would not stick straight up in the air, they would go off to the side. Because it's a little thing called gravity. They don't stick straight up. Even if it was plastic surgery, I don't think they stick straight up. And if you're asking how I know this, I have boobs, I should know. Mind you, they're not F-cups, but they're big enough where they would obviously fall in place. Even small ones would fall in place. They wouldn't stick straight up in the air. I mean, I don't know. you can definitely tell a guy wrote this by how they're describing how a woman's boobs stuck straight up in the air. It's like, no, it doesn't work like that, you fucking idiot. Maybe if you actually got a girlfriend, you would see that that's the case. I grabbed hold of them and felt how big and soft they were. Lying next to her, I spent about a half an hour kneading her tits. Even though Masato was out cold, she began to moan in excitement. This was the first time I'd ever touched a woman's body, and I was as hard as steel. I love how they forgot the apostrophe S. I took her long, fat nipple into my mouth and began to suck it. Masato groaned. I got a pleasant surprise when warm, sweet milk flooded into my mouth. So that explains why her tits were so big. Now explain something to me, people. Is Masato supposed to be, like, pregnant in the Evangelion universe? Or is she supposed to be, like, pregnant, or does she have a child in this fanfic or something? No, I don't think they mentioned that she had a child at all, so why would her boobs randomly be producing milk? It doesn't work like that. Unless someone is constantly sucking on her boobs, they would not be producing milk. So, this is wrong. This is wrong. Doesn't work like that. We're not cows. You can't milk our boobs and have stuff come out. No, it doesn't work like that. Excuse my stumbling. I suckled and suckled her, wanting to get every drop from both breasts, twisting at, biting at her nipples to make them flow more as I was getting more and more excited until I ended up shooting my load all over her smooth tummy. I scooped up my hot white jizz with my fingers and held it to Masato's mouth. She started sucking all off. It was true. She was a total slut. I'm sorry, but how exactly does that make her a slut exactly? I never understood the concept of that. You know, it's perfectly fine for, like, the male character to go around fucking as many people as he wants, you know, probably looking up all the females' juices. Yet if a girl does the same thing, she's automatically a slut. So if a guy does it, are they like a man slut? Are they a man whore? Can you clarify? Or is this just... Okay, sorry, I'm getting into my own personal anger with this story, so let's move on from that before I explode. I looked at her pussy. It was smooth and shaved. I could smell her excitement from what I had done before. I spread her legs and slid two fingers into her cunt. She was good and wet. I licked her cum from my finger. She tasted great. Well, seeing you just did the same thing to her, I guess that would make you a man whore. Congratulations. My cock hadn't even gone down a single bit from before, so I used it to impale her cunt. Just say the word vagina. Why do people feel the need to say the C word like that? I slid it right up to the end. Masato arched her back and moaned again and again. Her inner muscles squeezed me and I began to fuck her as hard as I could. Masato, you fucking slut. You like being raped by me, don't you? Don't you? She started to orgasm as I fucked her so hard that her pussy began to bleed and her juices squirted out of her. Now, the only reason why she's enjoying it is because she's unconscious and you're pretty much raping her unconscious body. Even if she's enjoying it, it's still considered rape and you're still doing it without her consent. I was in heaven. She'd led me on so much. Now here I was, fucking her brains out, and she couldn't do anything about it. So because she supposedly led you on, you felt the need to rape her? Does that really make it justified? Does it? I screamed as I cummed, dumping one of my biggest wads of jizz into the depths of her cunt, filling her womb, doesn't work like that, and making it squirt out of her, doesn't work like that. As I did so, I squeezed her tits as hard as I could, causing milk to spurt into the air. I wiped my dick clean on her hair, making sure I let some cum drip on her face. Just to think, I could fuck the head of nerve operations whenever I wanted and she would not be able to stop me. She wouldn't even know who had raped her. She wouldn't think it was me, Shinji-chan. She might even get pregnant too, because there was no way I was going to wear a condom. Congratulations! You won the Asshole of the Year award. I still had a whole bag of whatever the drug's name is left, so there was lots more fun to be had. I thought that I might take her up the ass next time. Asuka better be careful how she talks to me, too. So, guys, if a woman's kind of pissing you off and you don't like the way they treat you, or you don't like the way they talk to you, drug them and rape them, because that's always the best solution. As I went off to my bed and left her asleep on hers, Pen-Pen watched me leave. He looked very happy, and there was some blood on his feathers from when he had a nosebleed. I wondered if he would like to join in fucking Masato next time. The end. And yes, all the other fanfics in here are about this same character fucking the same girl, and then some. I think he starts to fuck some of the other characters in later stories. So, that's pretty much what these stories are. Can you understand why I was pissed off by reading this? So much so that I felt the need to do this episode as my real self and not as the fanfic critic character. Because this is just disgusting. I know it's a fanfic and stuff, but this isn't something that's worth reading. There's no plot. There's no character development. It's just this little piece of shit of a character raping another character just because he feels like her, just because he feels like that she's not treating him right. You know what? Nothing justifies rape. If a girl wears revealing clothing, that doesn't mean it's okay to rape her. If you drug the person and are raping them and they're acting like they're enjoying it, that doesn't justify raping them. It's still wrong. And just how this person's making women come across in this fanfic, oh my god, she's enjoying it, so she's automatically a slut. No, it doesn't work like that. This fanfic was disgusting. And the fact that they wrote multiple stories about the same subject matter is just disgusting. It's not the worst thing I've read, but it was definitely one of, it was up there, let's put it that way. It really was up there. I mean, you can have rape in your fanfics, but you need to use it correctly. This is not the right way to do it. If you're just going to write a fanfic about this character getting raped over and over again because you possibly don't like the character, then something is wrong with you. Here's my solution. If you don't like a character, then don't write about them. If you don't like a TV show, then stop writing fanfics about the TV show. If you don't like a movie, then stop writing fanfics about the movie. Problem solved. I mean, I don't understand why some people can be so stupid when it comes to stuff like this. I really don't understand. Alright, well, thank you for watching today's episode, if I am to say the least. And yes, this is episode 198. Sorry that it was a bit late. Episode 199 should be airing either later this week, probably not, or sometime next week. And, yeah. Hopefully next season my episode scheduling will be better. We'll see. Well, thank you for watching, and don't worry, the fanfic critic herself will be here for next week's episode. So, have a nice day, guys.